So let us try to understand blanking and piercing operation, which is performed on punching press machine, and the various types of stresses which are induced during this particular operation. So as the punch moves in the downward direction, it creates a hole inside this particular MS plate and the blank will fall down. The hole which is created is known as the pierced hole, and this blank is known as the cut blank, and therefore this operation is known as blanking and piercing operation. Now let us see the various components which are there and how the stresses are induced over here. So as you can see over here, this is the punch having diameter D. This is the mild steel plate, MS plate. This shows the direction reciprocating motion of the punch tool, and this motion is obtained by the punching press itself. Now when this particular punch tool, it moves in the downward direction, it touches the plate and there is a localized compression. This localized compression is nothing but it is known as crushing. So when it touches this plate, then this is the area, as you can see over here, this is the area which is nothing but the area resisting crushing or compression, and that is known as, and that is equal to pi by 4 d square. So the difference between the compression and crushing is that the crushing is nothing but localized compression. When this particular punch tool, it enters inside this particular plate, then the plate will get sheared off and there will be a hole which will be obtained over here, and that hole is known as the pierced hole. So the punching force will be tangential to this particular area, and therefore this is nothing but the shear that will be, this is nothing but the shear operation, and therefore the area resisting shear is indicated by this hatch portion. So this area resisting shear is nothing but the perimeter, that is pi d, multiplied by this thickness, that is d of the plate. So it is pi d d. So in this way we can say that during this particular operation, both crushing as well as shear is crushing as well as shear stresses are induced. So using this particular concept, let us try to understand how to find out minimum diameter of the hole that can be punched. So first we'll consider the crushing. So crushing stress induced will be equal to punching force divided by area resisting crushing. Crushing stress is denoted by sigma c, so it is equal to p divided by pi by 4 d square. Now cross multiply by this pi by 4 d square over here. So pi by 4 d square into sigma c will be equal to the value of p. Then consider the shear. So shear stress induced will be equal to punching force divided by area resisting shear. So shear stress is denoted by tau or fs, punching force is p, and area resisting shear, just now we have seen that it is perimeter into thickness, that is pi dt. Again cross multiply by this pi dt to this tau, so that we will get p is equal to tau into pi dt. So once again write down these two equations again. Now as the left hand side is same, we can equate the right hand side of both these particular equations. So equating RHS of these equations, we can say that sigma c into pi by 4 d square is equal to tau into pi d t. Now we'll cancel out certain terms over here, so this pi will get cancelled out. One of the diameter d term will also get cancelled out. So we are having sigma c into 1 by 4 d is equal to tau into d. Now cross multiply by this 4 to this particular term. So sigma c into d is equal to 4 tau t, and therefore diameter d will be equal to 4 tau t divided by sigma c. So this is the minimum diameter of the hole that can be punched during this particular operation.